Hey guys, it's Keith here from Kegland, and just doing a quick video on calibration of the Robobrew Generation 3. The new Robobrew Generation 3 has a calibration feature in there, so you can actually calibrate the temperature on the front of the unit. But also I wanted to explain how the Robobrew works to make sure you can work out if calibration is actually necessary or not. So firstly, I'm just going to pull up this CAD drawing here and show you a little bit about how this works. Let me do a cross-section here. Alrighty, so looking in the Robobrew, it's important to understand that this is actually a rim system. So that means it's got these electrical elements here, and the electrical elements here are heating wort directly. So I've got the outside one here, the higher wattage element, and then the lower wattage element just in the middle there. The other thing is you then have to understand where the placement of the probe is, which is just on this outside section here. I can actually pull up this photo here, just give us one tick. Okay, now this is a photo just looking into the Robobrew, and you can see, as I was saying before, the elements on the outside sitting here, and there's another element on the middle here. And then you've got this little bit of stainless steel here, and that's actually the temperature probe. So because this is a rim system, we intentionally put this probe very, very close to the heating elements, and there's a very, very good reason for that. So it's always going to be reading the hottest wort in the system, because it's reading the wort which is right next to the element. And the reason for that is we want to make sure we don't overheat that wort. So if we've got a set temperature on the display over here, and we set that at, let's say, I don't know, 70 degrees, we want to make sure that if the temperature of the wort right next to this element exceeds 70 degrees, it kills the power to the element straight away. And the only way we can do that is have this probe very, very close to the elements. Otherwise, if you didn't do that, then the temperature could rise too much. You'll end up scorching wort and end up with a very sweet and sweet beer with lots of unfermentables in there. So that would be bad news for all you guys. So we do get some guys who come to us and say, well, how come the probe isn't in the middle of the malt pipe? Because that's the temperature I really want to know, is what's the core temperature of the malt pipe, where the grain is. And this is exactly the reason why. And we used to get some people who come in and they have like a handheld probe thermometer or something like that, and they'll jam it in the top of the malt pipe where the grain is and say, hey, wait a second, this temperature is higher than the temperature. Oh, it's lower, sorry, than the temperature which is showing on the display. Look, it's not a bad idea. Look, some people get a probe thermometer and use it in conjunction with the temperature readout on the display. But you will notice when you start recirculating in this unit, the two temperatures will get closer and closer together. As you get more and more liquid flow out here and it comes in the top, gradually the grain heats up closer and closer. And maybe after 5 minutes, you could end up with a temperature which is maybe as much as 6 or 7 degrees difference between the core, temperature in the middle of the malt pipe and the display temperature. But then after sort of say 20 minutes, half an hour, should be getting very, very close to the same. So it's really, really important to understand that, because I think in most instances people won't need calibration. So I wouldn't jump into calibration straight away and jump the gun there. I would probably just make sure that you fully understand that that's the case with the way that this is designed, before you make any changes like that. I should also say that if you insulate the sides of the Robobrew, that will also bring the two temperatures closer together as well, because you will notice there's a bit of heat loss. So if you've got the hot wort down here, the more heat loss you have, then the bigger the difference is between the wort which is actually coming onto the top of the malt pipe here and the temperature which is down the bottom here next to the element. So it's well worth investing in one of the neoprene Robobrew jackets, I think, as well as saving some power and saving some money too. So that's pretty much it. Now I'll just show you how to do the calibration.
The Robobrews prior to Generation 3, they didn't have any calibration feature on there, but the new Generation 3s, if your probe is slightly out or a little bit off and you can measure the temperature with a different thermometer or something like that, and you realize that you need to correct that, you can calibrate the unit. So let's say, for instance, I'm reading 50 degrees on the display here, but actually I've checked the temperature and actually it should be 55 degrees, let's say. So I know that my displayed temperature needs to increase by 5 degrees. All you need to do is you can go into auto or manual mode, it doesn't really matter, but then click on the time button and then hold it down, and you can see, there we go, and then it goes into this calibration figure setting. So I'm going to increase this to 5, Now you can go all the way down to negative 10 actually, to positive 10, but because I want to increase the display temperature by 5 degrees, I'm just going to go like that, then hit the play pause button or jump back to the home screen. And as you can see, it's jumped up by 5 degrees. So that's pretty much how to use the calibration feature. It's pretty straightforward. Look, generally speaking, you won't need it. I definitely would suggest most people don't use the calibration feature because the probes are generally pretty accurate, and we pre-calibrate these before they leave the factory. So you shouldn't really need this feature, but anyway, it's in there just in case.